This piece so much, and because I think there is so much to do.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go back to the very beginning, and I want you to try something for me. So, just in terms of just reading this music, there's so much. It's so interestingly done. When a composer writes all the dynamics and everything like that, but there are other clues that always have to be taken really, really seriously. And one of the most basic is, are the notes going up or down? I'm serious. I don't think that's a... And if you go back, In the Bach, I was talking about how the beginning of a slur is usually the emphasis. Mm-hmm. And that's actually, you know, we're in the 20th century now with Prokofiev, but I get that from Leopold Mozart, who, this is Mozart's dad, who wrote a book, and that's one of the things he said. When there's a slur, even if it's over a bar line, the first note gets the main emphasis. And I know that this isn't Mozart, but it's a kind of, there's a tradition there, and I wonder, in a place like this, when you have this falling, mournful thing, can you try to go back up to that D?
Yep.
Good. Let's just start it one more time. E flat, C
they're
sharp,
very close.
D.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Played the octaves like shockingly in tune.
Thank you.
Stunningly, beautifully, over the top in tune. It was amazing. But I didn't hear enough accent. And if I did a trade off, I'd like you to play a little bit more out of tune, but with more of an accent.
Okay.
Just kidding. I love it in tune. But can you try to really, what I think you can go for? So, and by the way, I've played in a lot of master classes and I've played a lot of performances, and I felt very, very uncomfortable in lots of them. And if you're not feeling 100% in control, one of the best things to do is to get to a place like this and go nuts.
Okay.
Seriously, to just to meet that negative energy with a really positive thing, take a risk.
Okay.
You're usually rewarded for it, and it usually helps the rest go better too. So why don't you just like slam these octaves. Okay. Big accents. Every one of these accents. I want to hear it very, very clearly.
Okay. I'll start like
one.
Fourth of one.
Sure. Don't make that a make it a stay really engaged. This is so fun. It's like a weird dance.
Mm-hmm.
So really do it again. That was so great. Do it again. I know that there's a decrescendo, but right now I hear pop
and then
pantomime.
Okay.
And I'm right here.
Mm-hmm.
For somebody way back there, they're going to hear it less than me. And the violin strings, it's been a long time since we've been able to go to a live performance and hear a concerto. But I can tell you, as a performer, when I go to a live performance, even I am like stunned with how much louder the E string is than the A, than the D, than the G.
Mm.
So your A string, yum, boom, is gonna pop. So
okay.
No matter what you do, if you try to play two even pitches, it'll probably still sound brighter on the first one. Now,
okay.
You can still try to do a slightly less big pitch, but try to do like a lot more than you're doing.
Because
okay. it won't be, it sounds so good in the practice room to go shum, because you can hear it, but you know, 6 inches.
Mm-hmm.
And think about, 60 feet.
Okay.
Jump, boom. And just keep in mind that the physics of the violin are on your side. The A string is going to be louder anyway. Yeah, and again, it was not an offensively loud pitch.
Yeah.
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 better to go. Because all of a sudden, that's a bigger dynamic. Mezzo forte. And good is more convincing to me than buddy. Can you try that? Now that we've gotten this part, you hear how peppy this is? It makes it even more important that this is a true legato, though. Don't think. If you're hearing three beats, I think like one big long. Oh, that's another thing. I talked about our notes going up, our notes going down. Then you've got the chromaticism in this. And then slurs are massively important. Because all of these composers are pianists. And a piano slur is different than a piano. It's a phrase slur. Mm-hmm. So when you, if you give it a second life, I think it's good to. He gave you the second life right there. So just really get into the textures of this too. Because then when you get then it's even more of a change. And what's just absolutely essential in any piece you play, and frankly like in any art form, is contrast. Contrast, I mean, if you go really over the top with it, there is such thing as going too far, but in a piece like this, it's hard to go too far. It's really crazy. Prokofiev is always fairy tales and, you know, this kind of fantastical imagery, so it's really hard to exaggerate these things. Second bar of seven. One of the best notes in the whole piece is that A flat, when that changes. Can you try that real quick? Take your time.
More time.
You know, I think you can. You don't have to vibrate it, you just have to lean on it. And if you think, gosh, I love that note, then something will happen. I really think.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because the first time I heard you play it, I couldn't tell you liked the note.
Mm-hmm.
Then this time I went back, it sounded like you were trying to make something happen, and then, I don't know, this, yeah. Don't worry too much about vibrating it. Don't worry too much about doing something with your hands. Just like, you know, it's good to kind of like sing things and just think about, I think about whether something's a vowel or a consonant and how I begin a bow stroke. You know, pa, as opposed to wa or wa. You know, but anyway. Just think about it in terms like that, and I think your technique will actually adapt to it.
Okay.
And know that you have more time right there. It is a good thing when you're a soloist to take some time and demand it. And I think you'll be able to catch her if she takes a skosh. Try it one more time. Maybe overdo it. Then we can go back and find a middle ground, but try to overdo it. And again, the first time we hear this piano,
mm-hmm.
orchestration's less thick, I think. Then we come back mezzo forte. Is it about the same, or is it?
There's horns the first time.
Yeah. pretty. There's so much like
chromatically.
Yeah, there's so much tension chromatically. So it's just so fun in this piece to lean into all of that. And I think we're running out of time. Nine through ten is one of the most, I think, important places. You just, we're out of time now, but go for broke. Every day in the practice room, you know, make a bad sound, you know, the, just as loud as you can play, because you have such a long way to go.
Okay.
So we have, we do this. I want to try, I could do the rest of the piece, but anyway, you sound great.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, I just, you can have even more fun with it.
Okay.
Thank you.
Cool. Thanks.
Thank you.